Assalamu alaikum. I'm Hussain and I am a law student. Today we will be discussing how a law student spends self-quarantine. Now, initially, I was extremely unproductive. I believe we all were. And it's very natural to be unproductive in such uncertain times. But I began to feel extremely restless. I was used to such a fast-paced routine, 8 a.m. classes, after-school activities, assignments due, readings to do before class the next day. And suddenly, I had all the time in the world. So, I decided to learn all the skills I never had the time or the opportunity to learn. As students of law, we are required to read hundreds of pages before class the next day. That makes the skill of skimming extremely important. I signed up for a course on speed reading on Umedi. It's only been a week and I recommend it to everyone. The original price was $120, I think, but they've brought it down to $12 now. Other than that, I realized that we should also change with the times and pick up skills accordingly. Now, we all know everything is slowly being computerized. I picked up the most basic skill of coding on Umedi again. It's called CS50. It's Python coding. Other than that, I also believe that it's very important to look after both your physical and mental health together. So, originally I used to go to the gym every day before class, but obviously I can't do that anymore since all the gyms are closed. So, I've incorporated a small home body workout. I do it in my lawn every day. 30 to 40 minutes. Other than that, as far as my mental health is concerned, I've started coloring. So I believe coloring helps in self-reflection and really calms you down as you realize what exactly you're feeling and why you're feeling a certain way and how you can make yourself feel better as well. Other than that, I've started reading a book. It's called Thinking Like a Lawyer by Elizabeth Mertz. And I found it extremely interesting because it basically discusses how like the role of language and its translation into the legal sphere. How social issues and problems turn into legal issues. So the book basically discusses how students of law are trained to shift from following a moral framework with a legal framework. And there's also a very interesting debate within the book as well, which is regarding how by adopting a legal framework, the concept of legal epistemology also comes in, which is basically when exactly evidence can be considered as legal proof. So it brings into the concept of how at times judgments might be made, which are contrary to what you might consider morally correct. Because the concept and the aspect of fairness is excluded altogether in the legal framework. So I found that extremely interesting as well. I haven't completed the book as yet, but I will keep you updated once I do. This book is also available online, PDF version for free. If anyone is interested in reading that, I'd highly recommend it. But until then, stay safe, stay home, and pray for the best. Khuda hafiz.